BX Project is a no-profit foundation about visual art and photography. If you want to help us, just drop a donation on buymeacoffee.com/berlinexplorer.
Welcome to this 50 minutes of experience. Today I'm with Mohamed Sohabi, and welcome, Mohamed.
Hello.
So, as you know, have a look if you can do it a bit, an introduction of yourself and tell us who you are, what you do as a photographer, and even also as a person, if you are not doing the photographer full time.
Okay. I am Mohamed Sohabi. I'm 37 years old. So I'm final portrait photographer from Iran. I started portrait photography when I was 28 years old. So I always fascinated of Baroque or Renaissance painting. So I always maybe doing my work to feel the pictorial technique in my most of my artwork, you know.
Let's say you are a full-time photographer. It's what you do to live for also.
In art community, maybe there isn't enough money to spend life. But in these days, in this pandemic, that COVID cause disturbing things in our society and another sanction that maybe we have in Iran, spending life is so tough. So I taking industrial photography as jewelry and something like that.
Okay. Okay, I understand. So because your work is really good made, I have to say. So, and I was asking to myself if you was surviving of that, because in a way, it's most of the work is made of portrait, I've seen a lot of portrait made on background. So I was thinking you had a studio and doing that as a main profession. But yeah, I understand your point of view, and also it's not easy to survive of that. Even I think for countries like your, where I think it's kind of also more quite common to take money for wedding, no, or celebration.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's talk about what is your main work. And what do you have some experience you would like to share with us about some of portrait you did it and the character behind this portrait and the experience you had to portray them and to spend some time with them?
Mm-hmm. In portrait photography, actually the identity and personality of the model is very important. So I always see the Yusuf Karsh technique that he said that the first things that the portrait photographer must do is break the maybe mask or something that always human like to hide behind it. And the first things of the portrait photographer must do is break this mask to reveal the true identity of the model, you know?
Yeah.
So this is very tough work that maybe the portrait photographer must doing some psychologist things with model or conversation, playing music in the studio, or maybe create some good ambience and atmosphere to have better connection with model. And the combination of the technique, lighting, the technique of working with the camera and psychology with the photographer and model, maybe create a good picture. And
you was continuing. Sorry, I stopped.
Okay. And I always like to depict a social issue in my work, because Iran has a lot of issues. For example, maybe the economic problems or another things, or maybe harassment or another abuses in my country. So Iran has a lot of issues, and maybe the Iranian artists don't any maybe concern to creating idea and concept, because when you walking in the street, or maybe when you read the news in the newspaper or another media, you can pop up an idea that, and after that you can create something special, you know.
I think I got the point. So let's say through this portrait you wanna reveal some of the experience also of the character you get in touch with. And to talk about another topic, I have seen in the last picture you post of also the portrait of these white horses.
Mm-hmm.
And how did you come up to the mind, or just was an idea, the things to shoot the horses, white horses, or it's something, a casualty happened in your life that mm-hmm. you got in touch with the white horse and you said, okay, wow, I would like to pick some shoot him.
This is my first time to capture animal. And the result, I think it's very fascinating, because you can see the sorrow and pain in the albino horse, actually. And another artist and another friend said that, this albino horse is very sad. And I think this is the difference between animal and human. Animal are so maybe unique without any mask or that want to hide, you know, but human always thinking about the staged character or fake character that you can see when you want to going into work, or maybe when you go out, or maybe if you want to go to the party, you can make another characters, you know. But in animal there is one character and mask. So this is very unique experience that I found out. The portraying of animal is very fantastic, because you can see the true identity of them.
And
other things is about aesthetic and beauty that fascinating me when I saw that albino horse, because the albino species is very unique. And one of my friends said me, I go to the maybe some a place to actually to visit some horses, and she said that there is one albino horses that and it's very unique, and after that I took some picture of it, you know.
Yeah.
So, and this is the result, the maybe you can see the picture full of sorrow, and maybe the aesthetic, the combination of feeling, sad feeling, or maybe melancholic. Yeah.
It's really interesting. have to say, particular, and for sure you can receive, in any case, the emotion of the animal, so the soul, and what is feeling that moment, probably. And look, I'm really curious to talk about particular things that your profile is full of different kind of exhibitions, prizes, and so on. And I wanted to ask you, how much time do you spend to apply to this submission? I think there are open call and submission of that. And if you spend your time to apply for them, or they are the ones they contact you?
I think what you mean is the creating and theories, and how much I spend with creating series or portrait.
No. What I am asking you is it's more common that you apply, so you submit your picture to the contest, to the open call, or what else, or there are more them they contact you to doing that.
And there are some photo contests that maybe all of the photographers know about them. And for example, the Prestige, for example, Lens Culture, actually, or another photo contest, that it's the common things that all the photographer must to know all of this content. So the first things that I always to do is creating some series or single photo, and when the photo contest released at the opening, maybe most of them emailed me, and after that I participate in that photo contest, or I see the maybe poster of opening in Google or Instagram and something like that.
So you did a series, we can say you did a series probably of 5, 6, 7 or 10 of this exhibition, and what was your experience, I mean, in feeling of doing all of this exhibition? Did you get in touch with some particular people that in a way fascinated you, or what else? Do you hear me?
Yeah.
Did you go to my question?
Yeah. Okay. You know, participating in the exhibition is very fantastic because you can print your artwork, you know. Unfortunately, the Instagram or another mass media or social media, it's very bad environment for depict the or show the artwork, you know, for another people, because the small size for the people can see digitally of your work. But in exhibition, you can print your work on the paper, on the final paper, with high quality of printing. And when I saw my artwork on the paper, I was shocked because the quality of printing and my work was very fascinating. And another thing is, when you go to the exhibition and hang out with other people, or maybe talk about the concept, or maybe another things that exist in your artwork, everything is outstanding, and you can have the opinion of another people about your work. This is very valuable, because in that environment, in the exhibition, the masters or another photographer or a student come and talk about professionally about photography. And another thing is very important to speaking and creating link with another masters or another guy actually can help you to improve and extend your photography, you know. It's very important to hang out with people or another, you know, what I mean. Yeah,
I understand. Do you remember some of the, you know, comment of someone in the exhibition about your picture?
Yes. Fortunately, most of the comment was positive, and this is the another thing, positive things about the exhibition is you can boost and extend your self confidence when you have positive comments about your artwork. Yeah.
So yeah, really, really interesting. I'm not for sure a lot for exhibition. I don't know. I mean, I can explain the reason why, but it's to put the topic in the end is just because I think there is not enough time to really relate to the picture, and mm-hmm. it's just more something related to aesthetical than a real connection with the communication is behind the picture. But it's also a good way, we can say, to connect with other people and to show to other people what you do and how do you do that.
Yeah,
really was nice to hear you and to talk with you today. And I thank you a lot for your time. And if anyone want to see the work of Mohamed, they can find your link in description, and you can check the latest work, especially on the website of Mohamed, to go a bit more deeper also in the kind of exhibition he did until now. And I thank you again for your time and to join in this podcast.
Yeah. I appreciate you to invite me. Thank you so much.
Thank you for listening to this podcast, and if you want to learn more about us, you can visit the link allmylinks.com, Berlin Explorer, or our website bxproject.com. And if you want to follow us, you can always get news from Instagram on our account bxproject. Thank you again, and see you in the next episode.